Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to The Gauntlet here on Hyper RPG. A couple quick announcements before we get directly into the game. There are many different ways that you can interact with this show tonight. Number one of which being with every single new subscriber, our contestants tonight get resurrected immediately. Now, in the past, we've done it to where subscribers add time to the clock, but now the new rule is every new subscriber, everyone who might be dead on the board gets to resurrect immediately. So it's a pretty powerful thing. Otherwise, they have to wait for a turn, which means less points being collected. So it's good to stay in the game and keeping things happening. The other ways that you get to interact financially with the show, which we really appreciate every time that you do, because it helps keep Hyper RPG alive and well and doing crazy shows like this with our wonderful friends over at Pathfinder. Every $25 that is tipped, you can either use the hashtag for trap or for potion. Now, if you do not say who you want it to directly go to, I will roll a random die and we will see who it will affect. But for $25, you can set off a trap, and we have a trap matrix worth of cards here. We also have potions. Potions help them, traps hurt them, which is pretty common sense, I guess. Now, I like it when you set off traps. It kind of helps me as a GM, and I'd appreciate if all of our tips went towards that. And I'm creating a new one tonight, a new one out of the blue. I didn't clear this with anyone. Sorry, Ryan. A $50 tip or more will immediately put a new gladiator on the map wherever they are. Wherever. So a $50 tip or above, I will roll a die to see which gladiator it is, and that gladiator will hit the map to cause ultimate destruction and really fuck up their day. Basically pooping in their cereal. Hey, Black Ice again, thank you for that 9-month resubscribe. So really appreciate that. All right, we are going to get started. So I'm going to go ahead and roll that clip and let's get into the gauntlet.
Gauntlet.
Alright, and we are back, and I just want to say, let's get things kicked off right off the bat. Let's start that clock. We have 2 hours on the clock to get as many skulls on the board as possible. We are starting immediately with our rogue, Coach Barney. As the crowd goes wild, you are the first to enter the arena as you enter into the Hall of Champions. What do you do, Coach Barney?
I'm gonna move right for somebody to kill.
Okay, Coach Barney, now where do you hail from?
Where do I hail from?
Yes.
Well, Pacific Northwest University.
Excuse me, Pacific Northwest University.
Yes.
What is that? I've never heard of such a place.
It's college.
It's a college. What are these colleges you speak of?
Arctic College.
Okay, I'm quite confused. So when you say coach, you are a literal coach?
Yeah.
Of what?
Sports.
Sports ball. We have a sports ball coach in the arena today. Now, Coach Barney, where are you moving on the board into this Hall of Champions?
I'm going to move right for that closest statue. I'm curious what's there.
All right, go ahead and go for it. You have six movements there. As you get right up on the statue and wonder at its magnificent beauty, its giant gold presence looming over you, it starts to crack and move around as rock begins to crumble offside of it, and there's this weird glow that it just bursts out from inside as all of this statues inside the room start moving as they look down upon you.
You will fear me! We are the great masters of the gauntlet!
I don't think so.
Fear me!
No, I think you're gonna fear my my big club.
That sounds slightly sexual, and I'm uncomfortable with this statement.
I've heard that somewhere before. But, I think you need to get knocked on your ass.
So you're going for an attack?
Yep.
Now you're a rogue, and you're just going head on
fighter.
There. Oh, you are a fighter. Sorry, I was mistitled. I'm going to ask Rai to go ahead and fix that document really quickly if he can. Make sure I have all of your proper... Nope, I have all of the wrong stats. Every single wrong stat on the document here. So we're gonna get back to your attack in just a second. I might be on the wrong sheet, actually. Actually, I have your stats on another sheet, so I'm gonna go ahead and go for that. So go ahead and give me a roll for that attack. It's going to be a d20 plus 12.
19.
That is... it's enough to hit.
I love it!
And so as you make that attack, let's go ahead and roll for your damage. Now, you're a damage for that attack is going to be 1d10 plus 9.
11!
That also hits. So as you take your club and ram it directly into the face of the glowing gold figurine, he immediately bursts out from all angles. You realize in that hit, they are extremely squishy.
I like squishy.
So go ahead and roll a d6 for me.
6!
Right off the bat, we've got 6 skulls on the board. The crowd goes wild. Yeah. Immediately, the crowd just erupts in applause at the
Get
blood
them,
that
coach.
Has already been...
Get them all!
So what athletics is going on?
You always wondered what athletics is for. Now you know.
Next up, we have Chantrell.
Yes, I'm Chantrell. I'm a wizard. I teach research for finding the magical properties in mushrooms. And I would really like to win this today so that we can get more money for my research.
Wait, excuse me. So you research mushrooms?
I do. They're magical. They open parts of your brain you didn't even know
could
exist.
Oh, so specifically mushrooms that are... Okay. Are you on shrooms right now?
Maybe.
The crowd goes wild. All right, so what would you like to do, Cantrell?
Chantrell,
great. What's your movement?
There's an H. I kind of want to go into this mushroom area.
So
naturally.
Immediately running away from the center of the starting hall here into the wooded mushroom, kind of just drawn by the power of the shrooms.
6.
As you enter the arena, you feel the ground start to crumble beneath your feet.
That's no good.
Am I high? Mm.
As you are unsure but what appears in front of you and whether or not it is real, but force of nature enters the battlefield.
Woo! A talking tree!
I'm guessing that she is not even close to having that animation ready because no one's ever just immediately jumped directly into a room before. It looks like it's not ready. That's great. We're going to continue on there. Oh, there it is. Okay. So force of nature entering the battlefield. A giant wooden creature that's towering over the top of you. Now, you did just make a movement. You still have time to attack if you would like.
Do I want to attack him or do I want to talk to him?
It's up to you. Would you like to start a conversation?
Yes. Hi, Mr. Tree. What kind of mushrooms do you have in this area?
Tree.
That's not a mushroom.
Leave me alone!
Pun, highest form of humor.
What?
Well, that's not very nice. I'm trying to start conversation.
Tree!
I'm gonna turn and pick these mushrooms right here.
Oh, great. So, not using her attack, but instead picking mushrooms. Can I go ahead and have you roll a d6 for me?
Okay. 4.
Great. Those mushrooms had no effect on you.
Oh, good. I add them to my collection.
All right. Next up, we have Professor Felgrim Shanks.
Yes. Professor of Ethics and Law at Pacific Northwest University. Also, Professor...
Wait, where is this university you all speak of? You are in the middle of an arena.
Yes, but our funding
has
been cut.
In the inner sea region.
Yes.
Please show me. Where on the map are you located? I am quite curious here.
Northwest.
Northwest.
The Grungir Forest, of course. The Grungir Forest.
All hail from the university near the Grungir Forest in the Pacific Northwest region. Well, I must assess the situation very carefully by making my way over to my barbarian friend.
Okay, great. So once again, the crowd seems quite puzzled. The crowd starting to get a little bit
very gingerly. I walk over with a
little
hop in my step.
See, this. Let me give you a word of advice as your arena master. This crowd particularly likes blood.
Oh.
Oh, and blood they shall have.
And not research.
Yes, blood they shall have, because I am also going to toss a grenade.
And you are a fighter?
I am a rogue.
You are a rogue. Great. So it looks like Rai, the mess things up guy, your rogue and fighter are switched on our data sheet here. So if you don't mind switching those for me.
Nice now, need to go back to university.
Throwing
maybe
a bomb. So I need you to go ahead and roll that attack for me.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to be a +8 on that. What did you...
That would be, with a +8, 21.
Wow, okay, 21 definitely hits, and you're throwing that directly...
I'm throwing it right here.
Right in the middle. The crowd goes wild, seeing that this quite sheepish-looking individual took them by surprise, causing ultimate destruction by throwing a bomb directly in the middle.
The great statues of honor, you must respect us and bow to us!
Oh, and then they take the damage?
And roll 3d6. You don't need to roll anymore. That hits and kills both of them.
Yes. Yay!
The first d6 was enough, so the bomb hits directly in the middle.
No!
Excelsior!
Flying, disintegrated across the map. Go ahead. If you guys want to go ahead and remove the three statues that have already been destroyed off the map, and roll 2d6 for me.
Excellent. Mm.
Six! And five!
Oh my god! Right off the bat, 11 more skulls added to the skull counter. Wow, this is the highest number we've had out of three of our masters there. That is some quick skull movement that's just flying across the board as the crowd gets extremely excited. These professors that hail from the Grungir Forest of the Pacific Northwest, taking them all by surprise. But we are not finished yet. No, we have one more introduction to make. We have Chester Winthrop Covington, the
Doctor. Dr. Chester Winthrop
Dr.
Covington.
Dr. Chester, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, sir. I don't respect your position.
Thank you, Professor Emeritus of Psychology, and welcome to Psychology 101.
I respect you even less now.
It is a great honor for you to be here as my students today. And I
Doctor.
Do... Yes. Oh, am I having one of my moments?
Yes.
Oh, the Jungian psychodrama. I shall play it out this time in the role of the barbarian. Ah, I do enjoy this sport. Oh, let us go in this direction. Into this room.
So, excuse me on that. Excuse me. I need you to make a, I'm going to need you to roll a d20 for me.
Happily.
Plus a 4 for your reflex save.
Oh, most unfortunate.
Should have had me check that.
21.
Damn.
Yes, so that is still, thankfully, not enough.
Uh-oh. Most unfortunate.
As you go passing underneath the giant mouth opening, directly getting 1 foot through, a trap door comes slamming down on top of your leg, causing eight hits of damage to you as you are now trapped, unable to continue on with your turn. So it sees now that the barbarian, as the crowd goes wild, has spilled the first blood of one of our contestants on the battlefield tonight. And we turn now back to...
Symbolically, blood is very important when you are looking...
Had your chance! Muffed it!
Oh, yes.
It appears the crowd starting to murmur between themselves, uncertain of why these professors and researchers would split themselves up when they were so obviously outmatched by these giant creatures that fill the arena. We go now to Force of Nature.
Tree, leave mushrooms alone!
What?
As Force of Nature throws deadly pollen released out into the air and waves it in your general direction.
If you wanna get high, let me help!
Oh dear.
Alright, so...
I believe it is...
Run, Chantrell, run!
It better be organic!
Oh my gosh.
I hope trees are gluten-free.
Unfortunately, you are not able to withstand the attack as you breathe it in, quite curious by the spores that are flying towards you. You take...
We miss her.
Uh-oh.
5 hits of damage.
Well, that's just rude.
As the spores fill your lungs, causing you, almost like helium, to speak at a quite higher kind of vocal range there. Sorry about that. The helium kind of... present inside those spores. We go now to
the great master of I will attack you.
And he starts running. This individual on the left here, the gold statue, starts running directly towards our fighter. And goes ahead and makes a swinging attack with a sword.
No!
As he comes slashing down with his sword. Hitting you and causing only 1 point of damage as it kind of hits you directly on the helmet and kind of knocks you back a little bit, taking you off guard. But we are now back to your turn.
You kind of
get him, coach.
Oh my gosh! So
you kind of hit like a, I don't know, field hockey player.
Oh snap!
I guess I'm gonna have to show you how this is done. All my years of combat experience. We're gonna line one up. just like in 87.
Oh, wait, hold it. Hold it here. No, the potion is loving.
Hashtag Neona donates a potion for hashtag Chris.
Miriam, is that really? You, Miriam?
A potion.
Miriam, I've told you not to interrupt me when I'm teaching.
I would ask that you hand the drunk one of these interesting liquid potions here.
Pink.
Ooh, most beautiful.
Oh. Yes!
It's very pretty.
Pink.
No.
Chug that potion.
Chug that potion.
Well, I've never been one to pass up a kegger.
Never mind. Year's party.
You have to finish it or the potion will not take effect.
Oh, don't you worry, I will be taking it all down.
Just like Miriam.
Oh, did I ever tell you about our honeymoon?
You did.
If you wouldn't mind handing this potion down to the drunk for him to read out to the arena and let them know what has become of this strange power that overtakes him.
I feel as if I am euphoric with an aura that would make someone who considered me to be an enemy friendly.
That is right. So you can hold on to that potion to be used
at any
time in the future,
where
you can turn any enemy into your friend and fight by your side. One of the most powerful potions in the arena, but unfortunately not one that gives you skulls. All right, so you are in the middle of your attack. Thank you, Arena, for throwing that potion onto the battlefield. Now, do not forget that you can also send traps. I like traps, personally, traps.
Can I say
the word traps one more time? Traps.
Traps?
Traps. Okay, so you are in the middle of an attack.
Two of them, in
something
fact.
Symbolic.
Two of them. I'm actually going to take both trap. Of my
you know,
attacks on
backwards,
this guy.
It's just
if
spot.
I need to.
It's true.
All right, go ahead and roll for those attacks for me. The first one being a plus
20. Oh!
That's a
20.
All right.
32.
All right, go ahead and roll that second one.
Natural 20.
That'll be 23.
Okay, great. Do you want to just go ahead and roll that attack for me, if you don't mind? Your damage. Sorry, it's it's a D10 plus 9.
15.
For the first one and the second one.
15.
That's just great.
No! I will destroy you!
As you swing your club the first time, hitting out an entire chunk of his body as the rest of his body kind of falls down on the part that is missing, and you swing back the other way, taking his head clean off his body, ramming it through the audience up into the bleacher section as the crowd goes wild and they all fight over collecting the head of the fallen statue.
I didn't
even
see
as he
falls. Oh, you're all terrible!
Good
you're all
show,
terrible.
Coach! Good show!
I need you to roll a d6 for me.
Five!
Five more skulls
Coach,
have been
I have
added
a rather
to
large
you.
Piece of stone on
oh my god, this
is.
We are already up to 22 skulls right off the bat. Still a minute, an hour and 44 minutes remain in this arena. Now, there are currently no more enemies present within the starting area, correct?
Mm. That is correct.
That is correct. Okay, we go now to Cantrell.
Is this water?
It is a weird kind of sludge swamp.
That's going to be terrible on your mouth.
It's only about 6 inches deep. It will definitely get your dress a little bit.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'm going to go this way.
I need to get this thing off my foot.
You're trying not to get your dress dirty.
Yes. Three.
It's a new dress.
Just when the audience thought that this was going in a proper direction to get maximum skulls, or... Cantrell
helping my friend.
We have
runs
a plan.
Away from the battle as running. The crowd begins booing.
We have a plan. Do we have a plan?
Chantrell, the plan you found, my
never
dear.
Mind the booing!
No,
you're fools!
Going.
We're following a logical plan!
Sounded like most of
Professor Shanks, there seems to be stone on my foot.
Now, would you not like to attack in any way? You're just running.
Well, what can I attack? Can I attack this barrel?
This guy.
You could shoot him with those weird...
My lightning bolt?
You can shoot the stone, it's a golden thing.
Can I reach him from here?
I think you should
can
attack
you
he's
the
within
gold.
Range for a magic missile.
Can
you
I
know, I don't have, yes, I think a magic missile is okay. In range of the tree.
Okay, fine, I'll shoot my magic missile at him.
All right, so the magic missile is an automatic hit, so I just need you to roll your damage for me. That is 1d4 plus 1, and then we times it by 3.
Excuse me, hold on. Is that Sam?
Is that reinforcements?
I hope so.
Tavarek, no hashtag trap, hashtag Neonet.
That's right! Seeing you run away like a coward from the battle. One of the audience members throws onto the field an edible light pillar that you are unable to...
What?
Oedipus. I can speak on Oedipus indubitably.
Oh, and it's really pillar. Gross after the first hour.
Edible light? You like edibles, don't you?
Of course I do. Who doesn't?
The edible light pillar lands directly next to Cantrell. Now, Cantrell, so entranced by this edible pillar, tries taking a bite out of it.
Mm. What? It does taste good.
As you take that bite...
Like the fairy tale.
You, unfortunately...
Which one?
...take 27 damage.
Oh!
What?
As it mixes with the poisons that are already present inside your body that you seem to have forgotten cause you to speak at an elevated tone given the helium present.
I am speaking at an elevated tone!
Immediately, as the two chemical reactions inside of you cause the blood to begin to boil inside of you.
Oh, come on!
Oh.
It was a new dress!
Ah!
I need some Carmini mushrooms stat!
All right, now you can still launch that magic missile.
That would be a 4.
A 4 plus 1 times 3, that's 15 damage. The tree making his reflex save, though, as he starts to dodge out of the way, the missile just grazing past him, causing 7 on the
force
of nature there.
Looks like I'm going to have to take care of this tree.
7?
7.
Well, that's the start.
So you've got a long way to go on him, unfortunately. All right. Moving on here, we've got Professor Felgrim Shank.
Aha!
Love it.
The one who surprised the arena with his last turn, throwing a deadly bomb in between two individuals, causing immediate slam of maximum skulls.
Professor, I'll deal with this stone on my own if you'd like to help the rest of the faculty.
As you wish, sir.
Upon hearing you call them the faculty, the crowd begins to boo loudly. They don't take kindly to educated people here.
Clearly not.
I'm safe then.
Yes, they do have a soft spot for you in their hearts, given that you are a coach, and we all know what that means.
What does that mean?
Sex with the players?
Ew!
Cheerleaders! You were a cheerleader, weren't you?
Don't talk to me.
What are you doing? Just like it works.
Okay, so you've moved...
Like I'm going to double move this round instead of attacking?
Understood.
All right. And
there we
I
go.
In place.
And Chester... I'm not going to call you Doctor. Winthrop Covington III.
Covington.
Dr. Covington. Yes.
Covington.
Would you like me to do something? I would like to try to make this stone remove itself from my foot.
All right, if you don't mind making a reflex save for me.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Put some muscle behind
it.
Just
7.
Lift that thing right off your foot. Come on.
I will allow that given how low I rolled there. So the trap lifts up off of your leg and you're able to skim through onto the other side. Now, as you come to and begin to stand inside that room, you hear the sound of the lava start boiling as two of the arena's favorites start emerging from the lava, one on top of the other's back.
No.
Buddy and Blaze have entered the battlefield.
I think I'm having a fever.
Buddy and Blaze?
Who's that?
Which is which?
There they go.
Buddy is the large one and Blaze is the small one, of course. Put them on the other side of the lava pit over there, right?
Oh, yeah, other together. Side. Together?
Yes.
Like this?
Working as a team, you can put them on the same square.
Oh, I understand.
Oh,
lovely.
Buddy
like
is
trouble.
Carrying Blaze as Blaze is riding on his back. Blaze,
hey there, big guy. You've just entered the wrong room, motherfucker.
Your language, sir. Not appropriate for my classroom.
Is that gum?
This is my class.
Hmm.
You in my house now.
I do, sir. I'm unsure of what I can do next. I would love to come up and speak to you closely.
I will give you both of your movements, your movement and your attack.
Are these each one square?
Those are each 2 squares.
Ah, then 2, 4, 6. Mr. Buddy, I do believe I would like you to become my friend.
Hey man, get off my back. What? Wait man, you got some weird entrancing shit going on to me right now. I can't
believe it. I told you the wonders of
you. I can't resist this. Blaze, I'm sorry, dude. Blaze, I can't help myself. This man, he just overcoming me with his...
We call that the Covington effect.
Mm. So Covington, standing strong, commands Blaze to follow him as, Buddy, to follow him as Buddy immediately kind of joins his side and has become one with our team as the crowd goes wild, the euphoric aura entrancing Buddy and making him a part of the team.
Excellent, I've always wanted a friend like you.
Yeah, so have I.
That brains over bronze thing might
right,
work.
So immediately, and actually it's the big one that joined your side there.
Oh, even better.
Yes, the big one. Well,
That's who I was intending, so that
yes,
would be nice.
Yes, yes, and I know you were intending for that, but Blaze may be small, but he packs quite a punch.
I believe you.
Yes, so you now have Buddy is going to roll on as a part of your team now. Buddy, immediately, what would you like him to do, given that he is currently under your command?
Buddy, are you capable of convincing your friend Blaze to come along with us?
Hey, yo, Blaze, man, this guy's got a really good feeling about it, man. I really appreciate it if you came over and helped us out.
No, man, fuck that. I ain't cool with this at all. It's about time I teach you both a lesson.
In that case, I believe you may have to dispatch your former friend.
Oh, man, this really sucks, Blaze. I guess I'm gonna have to, you know, kick your ass, dude.
So, Buddy, laying out an attack, he can do two attacks, Buddy. The first one is a plus 12, that's 15. Not enough to hit on that first one. The second one does connect, though, and for that attack, it is... Wow, 15 right off the bat as he slams down on the top of Blaze.
Hey, man, I'm sorry. Shit!
Down, just like that. You guys, driving a rift between the arena's most powerful friendship, the most powerful friendship that's ever existed inside of this arena, immediately cut in two by this group of travelers.
Now, Ellis would tell you that friendship is actually not something you need. So I think this is going to be okay for you, young buddy.
Okay, let's get going.
Oh, Buddy, hitting Blaze for a lot of damage on that one. Blaze,
hey, man, that ain't cool.
Immediately starts to bring his hands up as the lava starts to rise up and around him, taking two attacks, one on Buddy and another one on Covington. The first one directed towards Buddy hits. The second one directed towards Covington also hits. The attack on that one is a D8 times 3. Oh, wow.
It's getting hot in there.
Yeah, you're not going to like this. 24 hits of damage.
Most unfortunate. I did not appreciate that, young Blaze.
As he just pulls the lava up from around him, throwing these lava balls at the two of you.
I'll teach you all to disobey me in my house.
Get him back to your house.
All right. As we now go to the other side of the arena, as Force of Nature sees the lot of you trying to run away from him, he takes his movement directly out towards that final water spout square there towards the main arena right there. Some more deadly spores of helium on group of three, all three. Let's see.
Anything
hitting.
But the helium spores.
Anything but the helium spores. Do you know what my voice sounds like at that pitch? I hope you don't find out.
Me too, but I have heard stories.
You're here.
All of you taking, the three of you inside that room taking 8 hits of damage and now all infected with helium spores inside of your lungs as well.
This is no good at all. I don't like it. Your fear of a high-pitched voice, Coach, is quite interesting. I'd like to analyze that later.
I'm not afraid of it. I just really don't like it much. All right. Reminds me of my youth and...
All right, Coach, it's your
camp.
Chance to retaliate.
Oh, I'm going to retaliate, all right.
Sound
it's
going to
be just like that coach that I had back in middle school. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm going to give him what for? Both hits.
Are you going for a power attack? No, wait, you're a fighter. That's right. So you're doing two attacks.
Two attacks.
All right, I need you to roll that first one plus 12 and second one plus 7. Hold on. The arena has spoken.
Before my roll...
Smalls, you are killing me. No. I am killing you. Hashtag thirsty, hashtag blood, hash sator dash crip, hashtag trap biting your ankles.
Wow, it's funny that you say that it's biting Smalls' ankles because, in fact, a terrifying and inconvenient foot snare appears from the arena as one of the disgruntled fans, much to their dismay that you all have split a rift between their favorite friendship, throws a trap onto the arena floor as it lands right next to your foot. Can you roll your your reflex save for me, please, okay. Cantrell.
Yes.
Is that a d20?
A d20 plus d20. 6.
Yeah. 16.
Unfortunately, that is not enough. So you need to make a full move away from Force of Nature, 6 spaces, away from Force of Nature out of pure fear. It's so terrifying. And all of you, take 1d8 plus 5 worth of damage. Unfortunately, every single one of you taking 12 hits.
I'm dead.
Of damage. As that trap, as you run away, the trap digs deeper into your ankle, causing it to hit an internal artery as you bleed out all over the floor, lying dead, removed from the arena. Immediately, we have our first death, and the crowd goes wild.
Not Chantrell.
Chantrell, my dear, did you just say something?
Chantrell, now... One.
No, she didn't make it.
One with the afterlife. Now let's get back to those attacks. Thank you for that trap. Very much appreciated. As the arena master, traps are my favorite. My absolute favorite. That first attack, if you don't mind.
That'll be an 18.
Unfortunately, the first attack misses.
Woof.
The second attack is a +7.
Nine.
Yeah, also,
nine.
That second attack misses completely. The tree.
Attack.
Well, you have to die, and then it goes away.
I can't be tough like this. No.
All right, Cantrell, you are able to come back into the arena. Look, you died right before your turn, so now you get to come back into the arena. And one of the corners of any of the rooms that someone you are on a team with is inhabiting, but you will not be able to make any actions.
That's fine. I'm not fucking around anymore. Really? I don't really care about the grant. I want to start my own mushroom shop so you fools can go fuck yourselves.
There we go. Coming into the room with the disgruntled Blaze.
Good to see you.
Joining the fray.
I think she's abandoned us.
Yo, why are you coming up in my house, little girl? I don't take kindly to strangers. Okay? You know, one of mine turned to you. What about you turning to me?
I'll think about it.
All right, keep that on your mind. We'll talk soon. All right, we are now up to Professor Felgrim Shanks.
Could you use a little help here?
Yeah, I can imagine you can.
Professor, if you've misplaced Chantrell, she's in the room with me.
At least he can pronounce
Sanctor,
my name right.
Sanctor Valimax.
You want to put a stick on him?
Sure am. Is this considered adjacent?
Yes, you can attack from there.
I mean, is it considered flanking? Or do I have to be on the other side?
You have to be on the other side.
That's what I wanted to know. Thank you. I will attack. Oh, wait, no. If I'm not going to be able to get adjacent to him, I'm not going to attack with that. I am instead going to put a grenade right there.
Just throwing a bomb.
So it doesn't hit my friend.
Thank you.
A bomb onto the opposite side of the tree, trying to throw it between his branches and landing on the other side.
It's a tough shot, but I think I can melt it.
Plus 10.
16.
Unfortunately, the bomb goes wide as it flies to a couple of the mushrooms sitting on the outside, disintegrating them upon impact, releasing a weird scent into the air that you can't quite place yet.
Is that you?
All right, we are now up to Covington.
Wait! The arena has spoken!
Hemoglobin for the hemoglobin, blood for the blood god, traps for the traps god, we mean Zach. Hashtag trap, hashtag ankle bite, hashtag dash crook for your roasted mushrooms.
The arena has spoken. They have not seen near enough blood in the last 10 minutes in this battlefield as they begin booing and throwing a swift and serious goo from one of their pockets, landing on Coach. It's a swift goo. You cannot reflex save against it. This single target takes 3d8 plus 15 worth of damage.
Ow! That's gonna hurt.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
How much was that?
I'm not.
Yeah, that's not going to be good for you. That is 33 damage.
Ooh. 33
damage.
That sucks.
33 damage. The arena has spoken! It is best that you please the arena. You make them unhappy and they will retaliate. Are you down, sir? Are you dead?
No, I'm still kicking.
Still kicking. That swift and serious goo causing some maximum damage, but The fighter is still up and running. Sorry.
Mr. Buddy, if you would please smack this friend of yours who does not seem to be interested in joining our special... we are doing here. I would be most appreciative, and I shall follow it up by giving him 1-4.
All right, so you're asking Buddy to attack first.
Yeah, all right, man. I can do that for you.
Thank you.
All right, Buddy, letting off an attack on Blaze.
Man, I'm sorry, Blaze. I don't mean to do this to you, man. I feel really bad about this. I just can't control myself. He's got me under sexual trance, and I'm just completely mesmerized by him.
Covington, friends?
Well, actually, I have been doing some work with Masters and Johnson's early research of late, and never mind. I'll show you the pictures later.
Both attacks hitting on Blaze. That's... Ooh, unfortunately only doing 6 damage on the first one and 3 damage on the second one. So a 9 total on that.
I believe I will have to power attack your friend.
I think you picked the wrong one to be your friend.
Well, looks can be deceiving. I should have known better than to fall for that. It's a common trap.
Size
matters. A 20. However, I powered attack, so it's a 16, which added to that makes it a 34.
A 34, that does hit. That attack hits, so go ahead and roll your damage.
Wonderful.
For me.
I shall roll this number now. Oh, bummer. That was an 18 plus 10 is 28.
28 damage as you slam into his lava-like small body as your axe hits the top of his head and it splits. And now he seems quite angry.
Yo, man. That is not okay.
I do believe you started this.
As you're holding the axe in his head, it starts to lift out from inside him as the lava starts pushing out through the top of his head, healing up the wound that you've just inflicted. As he looks directly at you, no longer concerned with anyone else in the room, focusing all of the blunt of his attack on you. As you feel the lava rising up underneath you, he lifts you up in the air and throws you against the back wall.
Interesting.
The first one hitting and the second one hitting. So as he throws you and you hit the back wall, he throws another fireball, slamming it directly into you. The first hit is 9 damage. The second hit... is 3.
Someone got sacked.
In the parlance of you, my young friend, bring it!
And we now go back to Force of Nature, who is no longer feeling quite up to releasing any more helium spores into the air, and brings its giant fists up and comes slamming down with all his might directly on the fighter that sits underneath him.
This is gonna hurt.
Yeah. It's gonna.
I can take it.
It's hurt, man.
No, I totally take it.
Oh, that one definitely hits, and that is 2d12.
Oh, I might not be able to take it. He might be a little bit like Cortez Kennedy.
Oh, Zach to join the death ranks.
Oh, that sounded like death ranks right there.
Yeah. 18 hits of damage.
Oh, yeah, that'll do it.
Christmas!
As he hits you and your body just goes limp, smashing down into the dirt, leaving a small impact crater from where you once stood. Once again, luckily for you, it is now your turn. So you didn't have to sit out for very long as you enter the arena on one of the 4 corners, but unable to make a movement. I would like to remind everyone that every new subscriber to this channel allows them to resurrect and create an action immediately. And if no one is currently dead, we bank it to where the next time somebody dies, they immediately resurrect. So it is quite powerful. And every $25 tip, you can either give them a or a trap. Traps are the best. Those are obviously the best. Or you can do $50 and above to bring any gladiator, alive or dead, into the arena. Now, we are up to Cantrell.
So, usually I'm a pretty peaceful person, but now I'm a little bit pissed off.
I don't blame you, Central.
Hey, wait, we were having a conversation.
About what? What can you offer me?
About you and I, teaming up.
He's kind of hot.
Yeah, but can you get me closer to my dream of a mushroom/tea house?
Man, that shit's stupid.
Well then, fuck you too. I'm shooting you now.
All right, the wizard laying out an attack directly into the direction of Blaze.
I'm going to use...
You don't at all feel bad for his small
stature?
Yeah.
It's clearly compensating for something.
There's nothing wrong with small people. I will be the first to say that. I'm going to use my lightning bolt.
Ooh, throwing a devastating lightning attack, which is an automatic hit. You just need to roll for the damage.
All right, that's a decent. A one. Times five would be five.
And if he makes his reflex save, that is halved. Which he does. He's going to take two.
You know.
I'm just warming up.
If you'd have come to my
You don't want to hear
preschool
it, coach.
Workout.
As you shoot that lightning bolt at him and it hits him, he just kind of stands there and he looks at you and he's like,
ew.
All right.
Gosh, where's all the females in this place?
Yo, bitter ends around here somewhere.
Sure
you keep looking for
more.
And you get stabbed in the back too. She left me a long time ago. You could really look for that if you want it, but it ain't pretty.
Big surprise, I'm gonna go find her right now.
Alright, next up on the arena we have Professor Felgrim Shanks.
Yay! Alright, well, it appears it is just you and I now, large tree man. I might just step away ever so slightly.
Well played.
And give him another grenade.
You are such a...
So you're throwing a grenade once again. Oh my gosh.
Please help.
Taylor Swift.
Swift goo, I do not approve. Red, bad blood. Hash grunt 2016, hashtag grunt for president, hashtag trap, hash sator dash crup, hashtag obey your overlord.
Oh my gosh. Cantrell, I am so sorry. This audience just does not seem to like you. They were so enthralled by your group at the beginning as you were collecting skulls extremely fast, but now that you have split up their favorite friendship and now insulted one of their favorite gladiators, they let loose a foreign and lethal mousetrap on you once again with the foot-like traps. You must speak in an accent for one entire turn. Accent of your choice. And that is one full round before we get back to you again. And a single target. Let me roll for it and see who this hits. This lethal mousetrap. Oh shit. Coach, you're currently not in, are you? Are you in a corner?
Yes, he's in a corner.
Great. I need you to pass a reflex save of DC 30.
I don't think I can do that.
No, technically you can't, can you? No.
Yeah, that would be a whopping
20 would
11.
Be an automatic success.
As you've just been resurrected into the field and you're ready to join back into the battle, this mousetrap that was meant to be thrown at Cantrell misses the mark completely, landing directly in front of you, smashing down on top of your body, splitting you in two as you are once again taken from the battlefield.
Who?
No, Cantrell, you have to speak in a foreign accent for one entire round.
That's
a shall I roll to hit then?
Yes, you should.
That was a vicious trap. I just want to say that.
Oh, you have no idea. Yes.
Good show.
So it's a hit. 26.
That will hit. That bomb hitting. Go ahead and roll your damage for me.
4, 3. So 11. Plus.
11.
Is it plus anything?
Are you asking if
plus
there's a...
Plus two. It's 11 plus two. Okay. So, no.
13.
13.
Got you.
Tree out! Damn it! Ah!
As it's the bomb goes off, splintering pieces of the tree everywhere into the arena. He's not quite happy by that. He's still got a long way to go, feeling quite confident that he'll be able to take you down quite shortly. And for those that are wondering, asking about the $50 tip to bring in any gladiators, we still have a gladiator thumper, a tyrant, bitter end, and ice. Four gladiators that could appear in the arena at any given time. We go to our, well, Covington.
Yes, Mr. Buddy, my friend, I would like you to move into a flanking position. I shall go to here. The two of us, unfortunately, will have to dispatch your short friend. I do not appreciate his attitude. I wish he had chosen a more peaceful route and been willing to join us.
Oh, family labouche.
But if you would attack, and I shall attack, we shall see what happens. Give him what far, pop, pop, all of that. That's probably going to miss. That would be a 22.
Yes, unfortunately, Blaze sees your attack coming from a mile away.
Probably because I get the flanking.
Still one away from actually hitting. Hearing you talk and in a most pretentious way the entire time you were heading for that attack, he's able to telegraph your move fairly easily and just step to the side. Very easily. Now, what do you want Buddy to do?
Unfortunately, we must continue to pummel your young friend.
Oh, man, dude. Man.
I would prefer that he played with us, however.
Man, I understand that I'm quite attracted to you and I can't look away, but I feel real bad about doing this. Do you think...
Swing!
Okay.
If you can convince him that the two of you will flee the floor, that would be fine with me, too. I see no reason for you to
need the skulls.
Well, I mean, you don't get any points if I don't die.
Well, I'm sorry. That's unfortunate. Then we will have to fight
I'm just trying to let you know how the arena works.
I appreciate the fourth wall breaking. If you would please smite your young friend, that would be most appreciated.
I'll do that. Okay.
The first one misses. The second one hits. The second attack causing... Ooh, but that's a good swing. 18 hits of damage.
Oh,
Blaze. Blaze starting to feel the pain as he stares up into his friend.
Why?
He's mouthing, why? It hurts so bad.
That's what she said.
Do you want some mushrooms?
He unfortunately does have time to retaliate.
Anybody else? We'll see.
He's still fixated.
I'm dead.
Well,
quite fixated on Covington.
I understand.
I think they are very good. Yeah.
No, thank you. I do appreciate the offer.
What's that?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
No, thank you.
Man, I'm gonna, ignore the fact that lady over there is trying to tickle me with lightning bolts.
No, the sound again. Miriam, please.
Ice, baby. Hashtag spawn camping, hashtag ice, hash sator dash prep.
What is that?
That means we are effed.
Yes, you are, as ice enters the arena.
You're not even...
The audience has spoken, and ice will rain down upon you.
I would have to disagree that the audience is upset with your ability to get more skulls.
That seems like a good place to show up.
Clearly, what's happening here is they're threatened by our
mental prowess
and physical prowess.
Ice comes.
No.
Busting through the wall. Right in front of Professor Shanks. But it is still, and thank you, Arena. You have the power in your hands to absolutely fuck this team up from ever achieving anything. So,
thank you.
Blaze takes his hits.
I need to start my
mind. On Covington. First one landing, second one landing. Mm. Both of them, as he grabs your head and squeezes your face as fire begins to engulf your hair, burning you bald. The first hit. The first hit, 24.
Okay.
The second one, 18.
Oh, that will remove me from the board.
As he picks you up by your skull and just allows it to burn through as your face pulls one of those Temple of Dooms, or actually it was Raiders of the Lost Ark, and just melts completely off of your skull.
That's what's up. Who else wants to challenge me in my house?
Moi.
Oh, yeah, what's that? Understand you. What language is that you're speaking? What is that?
I'm speaking French.
I can't understand a word you're saying. I'm going to ignore you.
All right, and we now go to Ice as he's now entered the arena.
Hmm. I'm going to hurt you, man.
I don't suppose we could negotiate. No? All right.
And he rams you with his horns.
Damn.
Ice making an attack. Whoo, wow. His attacks are fucking brutal. That hits. And, wow, this is not going to be fun for you guys. Not going to be fun at all.
When was it ever fun?
Mmm, well said.
When it was a game?
That's 24 hits of damage as he rams himself up into you, lifting you up off the ground and slamming you back down.
On the plus side.
I am not dead.
Not dead. Well, for now, force of nature, seeing you in a weakened state, shoots some spores in your general direction, throwing the helium spores directly at you. That is going to hit.
Please, mon Dieu.
Oh, no.
I say old chap tea time, isn't it? Hashtag potion, hashtag shanks.
Thank you, Paximo84. Oh. Give him that potion. Red. This could be the thing that saves his life.
Whoa. Please, let us begin.
Thank you so much.
Chug.
I may very well need this.
Chug, chug, chug.
I was barely a swallow.
Oh. You took it in one.
Mm, tingly. Definitely magical. What's it do?
Pass that down if you don't mind.
Bad gas.
Ugh.
3d6 plus 2 damage to all enemies.
Mm.
Do I have to activate this or does it just happen?
You can go for it right now.
Let's
if you
do
want.
It. 5, 6, 7.
That's
9 damage.
9 damage. Not really doing too much. I am sorry. Not really doing.
But you did hit.
Didn't really save you in that instance.
Nope,
thank you for the potion.
And,
we need more.
And now I imagine I die.
Most likely. Most likely. Wow.
Smells sort of like me after teriyaki.
All right. Absolutely. As force of nature hitting you with that attack, so I just got to figure out how much damage it's going to cause. Only 2.
I am not dead.
Only 2 damage, but it does infect you with helium once again.
Oh no!
Coach, you were dead. You can now place yourself somewhere on the board, resurrecting, but unable to make any movement.
I'm gonna put myself right over there by Shanks, and maybe we'll start on some teamwork.
Cantrell, her last turn with the accent.
Oh, mon dieu. I will shoot him with my... my fireball.
Oh, what's that?
My fireball.
I'm sorry, can you write that down for me? I can't. Or
fire
point. Can you point
ball.
To it? Can you point to it on your sheet for me, actually?
It goes poof.
That part, great. So the wizard shooting a fireball. Fireball, for those that couldn't understand it.
And fire creature.
Automatically hits, so just roll your damage for me.
It is a 4.
Those 9 damage. You only have 2 uses of that per
it
life.
Is times 5.
So 20.
Oh, sorry, I did plus 5. You are correct. 20 damage.
Yes.
Making his reflex save, though, only 10 damage.
As the, I will take it.
As the impact hits Blaze. Hey, man, what are you doing? And the fire causing no effect on him, though, as he just sucks it up. Kind of breathes it in, like pushing him back from the impact,
oh,
but sucking
wait.
Up the damage. And
classic blunder, hit the fire monster with fire.
Professor Shanks, you are up.
Oh, thank God, that's done.
Well, I am not in a good place right now. I think we can all, but not one to just give up. I can 1, 2, 3. Oh yeah, I can get them all both in a fire, in a grenade right here.
Throwing another grenade, lobbing it over the head. Oh my God, the arena has spoken.
This is always bad for me.
The crowd feels sorry for the gladiators and throws a hashtag potion to a random player.
And that random player happens to be Cantrell.
Cantrell, there's an H.
Go ahead and drink that potion up to see what it does.
I'll take blue, my favorite color.
Like the rings on those mushrooms you eat.
Thank you. Arena for supporting your weary travelers
Raising.
Today.
If I were on the field of play,
as
I
they
would
try
say such a thing.
To collect the glory and the million gold that awaits them if they are to become the victor.
I drink a taste of excitement. 1d12 hit point. Nope. Hit points restored plus 1 extra attack makes me feel good.
So you get your health restored to a certain extent there. Now let's go back to this attack.
Just one
attack.
For
your health?
You should have to use it right away.
No, she doesn't.
I don't have any hit points.
Great, then I'm going to go back to my attack. Let's see, that'll be 23.
Wow, that's your hit. And you are aiming that in the middle of those.
Or 1,012.
You hit Force of Nature, but unfortunately, a little long with that throw as it's out of range for ice. Your damage on that.
6. So 12.
14. 14 damage.
Okay.
Yeah, that
light that tree on fire. Oh,
screw you and your helium BS.
Oh, stop it!
As more.
I did stop spitting at me!
Okay.
And we are now back to Covington, who was dead, correct?
Yes.
Respawning anywhere on the map.
I'm torn to assist. I guess we'll do the assist.
As you spawn back into the lava pit, what would you like Buddy to do this round?
Buddy, we must continue to dispose of your friend Blades, and then this ice gentleman, I think, would be most uncomfortable with what you have to offer.
Man, I feel you on that one. I don't like ice. He's a piece of shit.
And he comes smashing back down on top of Blaze's head. The first one hitting. The second one missing.
Ooh. Take him down.
Taking 12 damage on Blaze. Wearing him down. Wearing Blaze down. Now coming back to Blaze. Once again, upon seeing the professor or Covington enter the arena, once again, he's distracted. He's already blocked out of his mind the fact that his best friend has started attacking him and would prefer just not to fight him at all.
That's
even
fine.
If he falls by his hand, he'd prefer just not to fight him because it just hurts too much. But he blames you and sets all of his attacks towards you once again.
If you would like a session after this, young Blaze, we could discuss where your anger is coming from.
Oh no, I'm really gonna fuck you up.
Hitting you with both attacks. The first one causing 9 damage. And the second one causing 24 damage.
Oh, that hurts. That hurts.
Clearly he is left-handed.
Lava balls directly at you as you respawn into the arena before you can even make your move. We now go back to Ice, who is just completely raged out of his mind and just starts trampling on the ground and running his feet as he lifts you up once again with his horns and slams you up against the back wall on the other side.
Over here?
Hitting you. Jeez Louise. He has a really high attack.
Sounds like Max.
Did you do more than 2 points of damage?
Well, I'm about to roll for that.
That's a really crazy trip.
Yeah, he does.
I look forward to you joining me, Professor.
Did you die?
I did.
Slamming him up against the wall, your spine exits your body from the impact as it's left almost as an imprint on the concrete on the backside. Can you move Ice up against the wall? Please. Thank you. As he's removed from the battle, the crowd goes wild. They are still stuck at 22 skulls, the strongest entry we've ever seen in this arena. And now, with only about an hour remaining. Now then, split
guys,
up.
Pick this we can up. Do this. Come on.
Oh, teamwork.
Let's take care of this.
I mean, we built a college together, damn it.
Everyone, I think it's your turn.
Gravity is there anyone left? Is there anyone left in this main room here that I can't see?
Me.
Yeah.
You're in the corner.
Yep.
Force of Nature is going to move towards that corner. Is that it? Put him all the way up on that, actually.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, moving there. All the way up on there.
He takes his giant left leg and slams it down on top of you, pinning you against the ground as he starts pummeling you with his fists.
Ow. Ow. Oh. I think that's a little extreme, isn't it? I mean, come on.
And that hits.
We only just met. You're acting like the dean of students acts when I'm in her office.
Naked?
Gross, gosh.
20 damage on that.
Oh.
20.
What a way to start the day.
I really feel bad for you guys. I'm rolling extremely high today.
Well, whoopsie fucking
we figured it was
that.
Revenge.
And Coach Barney.
Fourth wall.
All right, Coach, let's put some
I see
of your
what you did there.
Skill to test.
Yeah, we're going to go ahead and line up a couple of good chops on those legs. See if we can't bring this tree down once and for
all. As is holding you down, you remove your giant, what is that? Just a battering kind of...
It's like a big baseball bat, see, because I was...
We'll say it's wrapped with barbed wire, right?
Its name might even be...
I'm going to go Negan on him and just start...
I don't know.
Are you just going to chop the tree down?
Two solid hits if I can do it.
That's an 18.
That'll be a 30.
30 total?
30 total.
That first one will hit.
Second one is not gonna hit.
Definitely did not. That first one, go ahead and roll that damage for me.
12 plus 3.
12 damage. Force of nature just getting aggravated with you. Long way to go to bring this mighty, mighty tree down. Cantrell, you're up.
Chantrell, I'm going to throw the mushrooms that I picked over here at the feet of this guy, and then I'm going to light him on fire with him with my fireball.
Fireball will not affect him.
But the mushroom poison might.
Make the poison appear.
I don't know.
No, you
do gotta make it smoke.
Okay.
Like my stepfather always used to say.
Are you going to use your plus one extra attack, or are you going to
save it? Yes, I am.
No.
Okay, so you're making two attacks.
Two attacks. Can I use a magic missile for that second one?
Yes.
Thankfully, okay. You didn't.
So I'm throwing my mushrooms all over him, and then I'm lighting him on fire.
All right, go ahead and roll for that attack. Wait, actually, your attack automatically hits. That's right.
Yes.
So go ahead and roll damage on that.
So this will be a 1d6 times 5. 10. The first one,
as the mushroom hits the ground and you light it on fire, the fire does nothing to him as he soaks it up, but the smell of the mushroom starts to get in his head and,
hey man, whoa, what is going on? Oh, I've never been able to see in color before. Is this what the world looks like to the rest of you?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to bring to the whole world.
So he is now somewhat stunned as he takes the 10 damage, and you're able to then, by distracting him, get that second attack off with the magic missile.
Oh, it's a d4, sorry. Wrong dice. Good. That's a
well played, Central.
12 damage. As he's stunned, the missile hitting him directly in the chest, blowing out from the insides of him as he starts getting really kind of.
I don't know how much longer I can take this.
I didn't think that was going to do much, but...
You gotta get creative, guys.
Blade Chantrell, it was beautiful.
Professor Shanks, you are up.
That herbalism stuff really works. I need to show up somewhere
in the room, then?
Yes. Appear in whatever corner of the room you choose of any room you are currently, your team is in. Also, the arena, enjoying this game and how much it's been difficult for you. They've gone from getting bored to just having a really good time sharing between the group of them as many puns as possible throughout the audience, all to make fun of your disastrous performance.
Oh, yes. Glad we could help you. You'll be the one who's laughing at the end.
All right, Covington is now back fully and able to...
Oh, am I able to...
No, you just come in and that's it.
No, I can act. Yes.
Please just finish him off.
Back to the flanking. I'm afraid, buddy, we must again attack your friend... would you like to go first? Buddy?
I think you should probably go first.
Okay, then I shall do that.
Which probably means he's almost dead.
The power. Oh, I should have done the power. That's a 20, 30.
Oh, damn!
It's a 38, it's a 20, it's a big...
Yep, go ahead and roll that damage.
Hit, man.
There you go. It's 9 plus 16 is 25.
That will end Blaze.
Yay!
As you hit him in the head with your giant axe and split him, this time he's unable to actually push you back out with the lava as the axe goes all the way through him, cutting his little body in two.
Good show, boy.
A Blaze.
As this happens, you look up at Buddy and a soul tear starts trying to come off his face, but it evaporates as it immediately comes out of his body.
Oh. Buddy, I promise that after this is done, we shall take a moment and I shall have you through your grief.
A small child sneaks into the arena with a hashtag potion for hashtag coach.
Ooh, drink that potion up.
Drink it up. It's all about the purple.
Yes!
Purple drink.
It doesn't smell like grape.
Oh, it's not.
Mine tasted like pink.
That tasted like grape.
And if you would like to take this and announce to the arena this magical potion that you've been enchanted with.
Potion! Cure serious wounds. 3d8 plus 15. Hit points restored. I think I'm gonna need that.
You gonna save that one for now?
Yeah, I'm kinda trapped in a corner with some serious wood issues.
Yeah, I really should have popped up in the
Let's
other room.
Let's collect our schools!
Alright, roll 3d20s.
Oh, what do I need to do for the thing that happened?
That's it, you're rolling 3d20s.
Okay. That's a 6.
Higher.
That's a 6.
Higher.
That's a 12.
All right, 24 skulls added to the board as the crowd goes wild.
Yeah.
Long way to go in 57 minutes, but hopefully by splitting this party, they've been able to weaken them to more quickly take them out. Hmm. Now, what
Buddy,
would you...
Buddy, you still have something to do.
It was 23
I think you should
skulls,
destroy
not
that
24.
Gold thing there.
Great, so you're telling Buddy to just destroy the gold?
Oh, okay,
well,
man.
I guess he could go in there, that's
I
true.
I can do that for
so
you.
Much. Never mind, Buddy. Would you like to take a shot at ice? You did say how little you think of him.
Well, I could take a shot at ice. I would need to be in the other room to do so.
And you'd shoot him from here?
Yes.
Go, Buddy, go.
So Buddy makes a run to the opposite side of the room using the doorway as cover, kind of shooting little lava bullets at ice as they hit. I'm going to give them a +2 to their damage, given they're being shot on an ice elemental, but the same goes vice versa. That was weirdly electricity. And that first one actually misses. The first attack misses. And the second attack misses. Ice's armor class is extremely, extremely high.
Most unfortunate.
I'll come shoot him with my fire.
Ice, now seeing across the entryway, Blaze kind of shooting pot shots at him, starts running as fast as he can directly toward. Go ahead and move him 6 spaces, if you don't mind, towards that doorway there. Unfortunately, he has no ranged attacks as he's running full speed, and you see that he's heading towards Blaze to end him off. Force of Nature, now still with his foot on top of Coach, just continues pummeling him in the top of the head with his giant branches. Hitting on that attack for only 2 damage. I reach him pretty more than that. Only 2 damage. You're able to kind of put your hands up and block a lot of the blows now.
I learned that in boxing.
There you go, Coach. You're up.
Since I'm kind of dealing with this wood issue on my own, I think I'm going to do
like
my best
most of his life.
I guess I'm going to just have to do myself.
Like most of his life.
Beat it. You're dealing with a wood issue and you have to do yourself.
I'm going to have to beat it.
Fighting a giant piece of wood all on your own.
That's story of my life right there. All right. I guess I'll hit it twice.
All right. Going for 2 hits.
23.
That will hit.
And we're going to go with another 8.
8 total?
8 yeah, total, yeah. With.
Second one not hitting. That first one hits the roll that damage for me.
We got a big 16.
16.
I hit it at a good start there. You hit it pretty good. Got a little tired there after a few swings.
Unfortunately, Force of Nature still standing extremely strong as he continues to pummel you in your face. Cantrell, you're up.
Line, guys.
Chantrell, what would you like to do?
Wood.
I think the only thing I can do is, well, I can open this up, but I'm by myself, so.
Yeah.
I would suggest we join
yes,
and destroy.
That's what I'm thinking. One,
with a double move, you can make it there.
2. Do I have a double move?
Yes. You move twice. You don't get to attack
3,
this round. But.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12.
Oh, I see what she's doing. Well thought.
And that's it.
All right, that is your move. Now, how did you get that far?
I moved 12, so I can move 6.
It was actually 12?
Yep.
Yes, that's she went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Because each one of those giant...
Can I move diagonally?
She began here and she used these as 1 square instead of 2.
Oh, I see.
So, yes, I was going to say that is quite a long ways to move.
You would be right
giant
here.
Squares are 2.
Well, I moved 2 per them, but I went diagonal.
Yes, you can't go diagonal.
Okay, so I was... So... Where was I?
Okay. Yes.
So, 1, 2, 3...
The counting as the clock counts down is not helping them at all.
11, 12. Right there with him. Yes. Right behind him.
All right, and we move on now to Professor Felgrim Shanks.
I counted already. I can make it here.
Great. So that's your dual movement there.
Great.
I'm going to need you to make a reflex save.
I figured you might.
Oh, that door again. Forgot to check it.
The one that Buddy is in?
You get plus 13 to your roll.
Yeah, so 18.
18 total, that'll work. You were able to sneak through there quickly enough as it comes smashing down behind you.
Is the door still closed then?
No, it raised back up.
Ah, then I shall attempt to move to here.
Oh my god! Poop Galactic! I didn't hear the sound for some reason.
What's Poop Galactic?
Where's the subscriber noise? Was now just officially announced as a new subscriber to the channel.
Yay! Welcome, Thumper!
Thank you for subscribing. Sorry that there it is. There we go. Dance.
Subscriber.
Thank you for that subscription. Now, anyone who is currently dead can resurrect and remove immediately, and if no one is currently dead, the next time you move, you will be able to respawn immediately. Thank you for that subscription.
Nice.
Yay!
All right, so...
I think I'm going to need that.
I think both
What was that?
I will get hit by your thing again.
Oh, what was your... what
Not
you
good
roll?
Enough.
What'd you roll?
I rolled a 2.
Yeah, you will definitely get hit by that trap as you take 11 damage as it slams down on the back of your leg, trapping you immediately.
So yes.
The second time didn't seem to learn after the first time, quite the professor you are.
Go for it, coach.
All right, well, actually, you've got Buddy up first.
Oh, that's true.
What would you like? Oh, hey, man.
I would like Buddy to lift the thing such that I can be free on my turn.
Yeah, I can do that. He just grabs it and lifts it up. And when
up
he does
so
it, he kind of breaks the wall, pushing it up out from... Oh, I'm sorry, man.
No, that's perfect.
That.
I did not like it. It's cool, buddy.
All right, so
it's
that is,
cool, bro.
Look, I'm using slang.
Buddy's turn. We now go back to Ice,
cool,
who continues
buddy.
His charge at full speed, ramming into Professor Shanks there.
I just got him!
And pushing him back up against... Covington's head that's sticking out from the wall there.
Oh! Oh! How are
that
you doing,
will
Professor?
Hit on both of you.
Once again, Covington's head up my ass.
It was one faculty dinner party. We don't have to talk about it here.
It
pausing,
was two faculty dinner parties, and we do need to talk about it.
12 damage to Shanks and 10 damage to Covington as you're literally pushed directly up against his head, sitting on top of him there.
I'll actually go ahead and take one this time, because...
Right? See?
You've died less than
right?
I have.
See? So. The power of the mushroom. Did I tell you I discovered
all right,
a
and
new
then Force
species?
Of Nature decides to stop pummeling you on your head and put its hands together and push a bunch of spores directly into your mouth. But also, as he does this, it spreads out to the rest
That's
of the arena, heading the two of you on the opposite side as the fumes come around to your area.
Taste my seed.
See who all it hits.
That's not pleasant smelling, dude.
Oh shit. Well,
Force of Nature might need a
unfortunately, you seem to have become immune to his spores as they enter your bloodstream.
Well, imagine that.
After using them so many times and it affects none of you. That's unfortunate.
That was
all
a good
right.
thing that I got the mushroom from you right there. I mean,
lucky.
Just saved my life.
Oh my god, Vanus Aaron, just subscribe! Alright, that is now two resurrections we have on the board, which
Yay!
Is going to come extremely handy. Coach, you are up.
Okay. Well.
Two Rylos, we cannot pause the clock because we have a show immediately after this one. They get resurrections for free on every new sub, which is more powerful than the time it takes to dance.
That first attack is a 15. Second attack is a 25.
Yeah.
The second one hits.
Well done, Coach.
18,
that one hitting extremely hard.
That's what
she out
said.
Of him.
Force of Nature still standing extremely strong, though.
Still standing.
He seems to be all right.
Cantrell, you're up.
Cantrell, I'm going to hop over. Can I get behind this guy like that?
I need you to make a reflex save as you run.
The thing does
actually, it has been broken. You are correct. Yeah. So you're going.
I'm going to shoot my lightning bolt right in his butt.
Great. That's a really good idea. So you shoot the lightning bolt. Go ahead and roll that damage for me.
Which one's the lightning
bolt? Don't question. She's rolling for damage.
No one's.
Ah!
That's 5 damage.
5.
5 damage as the lightning bolt hits, and since he was had you two pinned and Buddy behind him, you hit all 4 of the targets that are in a row for 5 damage, every one of them.
It's only 5.
You got all of us.
It was a straight line. How did I get everybody?
Because he's actually pinned behind him. You can't see. It's just, yeah.
Professor, I believe it is your turn.
Is it?
Yes. I feel singed at the moment.
I'm in a good spot right now, despite the fact that you just electrocuted me a lot.
I only electrocuted by 5.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You got this, Shanks.
Yes. Remember when I electrocuted you? Oh, no, because it never happened.
That's because you can't get close enough.
That was me.
We can. You can flank.
Also, I know how to aim. I am flanking.
Good.
I'm very clearly flanking right now.
I understand.
And, oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Let's see. So, 26?
On ice?
Uh-huh.
Not enough.
Are you kidding?
I'm not kidding you.
That's almost as high as I can roll! Okay.
That's with the plus 2.
Is that with the plus 2?
That still wouldn't matter.
Oh, my flanking plus 2. 26.
Not enough.
Wait, it was 26. It would be 28.
Yes.
It would be 28.
Not enough.
Okay, yeah. I
don't believe
I technically cannot hit him.
Why?
Interesting.
But I can move, and I will.
Shoot.
There we go. Sorry about that. His armor class is extremely high. He's a tough little bastard.
I will move.
Is there a critical hit rule where we can hit him on a natural 20 or anything?
So I would allow that, a natural 20.
I hit him. My lightning hit him.
Because wizards don't have to roll to get through armor class.
Oh,
so
right.
Close. I will get a 28, which
not
will
enough.
Miss.
That will miss.
And Buddy, if you would please smack this.
I see Hyper RPG just said an AC of 31. Actually, it's 32 on this sheet here. An AC of 32 on ice.
That is insane.
I
can hit him.
Yeah.
Send him my way.
Buddy, if you could please hit this one.
I can hit him on a flanking net.
Buddy acknowledges your command.
Come on, Buddy.
Looks at ice and grins. Never liked that guy anyway. But his first attack does not hit. Second attack hits, though, and it's a plus 2 to damage. So that's... Oh, wow. So that's going to be 17 damage on ice.
Ooh, that's good.
Thanks.
Oh my gosh, the arena has spoken!
Well, let's see if they can live like renegades, or at least slaughter like them. Hashtag potion for a random professor.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Miriam.
Thank you so.
Thank you.
That's going to go to Professor Shanks.
Oh, he'll take it.
I like how Hyper RPG says that my graphic is wrong if it's not AC. Just to be clear, Rai, you printed out this sheet for me as the person who's in the chat room saying that my graphic's wrong. You made it, bro.
What do you think is saying that?
Probably Emily.
All right.
Things are getting testy here.
All right.
A little bit.
Your potion.
I didn't know you could see that from over in this corner. Sorry.
Testies or something else I have lectured on.
Spitfire. Well, gain 3 ranged attacks at 2d6 plus 4 damage.
All right.
I like that.
That is quite impressive.
That's
those are rolling
really
to hit attacks, though, so I can't use them on ice.
What is our time remaining?
So
your time remaining is 43 minutes.
All right, guys.
43 minutes remain.
You guys, and we need to get another guy.
Let's get them all just close to each other.
Doesn't tell you what
and
you're
we
going
really
on.
Need to think about where we're going to go after we take them out.
Yes, you're right.
I would just go boom, boom, boom. It seems to imply to me that you just do it.
It's not my turn.
Ah. Whose turn is it?
Who was the last person to make an attack? It was
Buddy. Was.
That's right. Coach. It was Buddy who made an attack, so that means we're back to Ice. We are back to Ice, who now has 2 individuals staying behind him, which is quite convenient because he turns quickly and takes you both, lifting you up by your throats and smacking your heads against each other.
Oh,
Batman style.
Ow. You knocked my mushroom silly.
Unfortunately, we've got, let's see, we've got...
I'm gonna have to call a penalty on that one. That's not right.
Unnecessary roughness.
Yes.
That's the wizard and the...
Barbarian.
Barbarian standing there. It looks like only the barbarian will be hit with that, though.
Oh, all right. We saved the mushroom.
The wizard being ducking out of the way before it can grab him, and he just grabs you by the throat and squeezes extremely hard, causing... Only 4 damage. Damn it.
Okay.
Only 4 damage on that.
Take it away.
On the barbarian, as Force of Nature, now realizing that the spores have no effect anymore and just wants to end this asshole once and for all, takes both of his legs and jumps up in the air and comes back down on top of you with all of his weight.
That's brutal. I want to roll out of the way of that terrible attack.
This one you can't.
I want to get crushed by...
As you take 24 damage.
Ooh, that's no good.
Can I use that Cure Serious Wounds card anytime?
Yes, you can.
How about now?
Someone's gonna have a hard time here tonight.
I would also tell you that you have 2 automatic resurrects from the chat room as well. Quite powerful. But you have a card, so you might want to use the card and save the resurrects for your team.
I'm gonna use that and roll my 3d8 plus 15.
3d8 plus 15.
3, 4, 6 plus 15 is 21.
21 HP restored. Congratulations.
Act below half. This is good. And I do believe that I'm going to retaliate and give that wood some more clubbing.
Giving the wood some more clubbing, Coach decided to do what coaches do best and whack it themselves.
21.
It's a 21 for the hit?
Yep.
That is just enough to hit.
Excellent.
Exactly.
And 10.
10.
Doesn't hit. So I'll do 64 points of damage.
Well, thanks, Coach.
64 points of damage, taking Force of Nature, continuing to whittle him down, whittling away at the wood, little bit by little bit.
Since I've died and come back, so I only have that left.
3 of them, yeah.
All right, Cantrell.
All magic missiles.
40 minutes remain in the arena.
I'm gonna use my burning hands and shove them in his ugly face.
Burning hands. Wow. Okay, so the burning hands is a 15-foot cone. 3 uses per life. That's 1d4 times 5 on damage.
Aim towards our fiery friend who won't
take. He won't take the damage because he's fiery.
Yes, away from me and towards the... Yes, well played.
Five damage there.
Yeah.
Ice just kind of brushes it off. I'm gonna give you 7 damage since it's a fire attack on ice.
Thank you.
But he's still standing pretty strong and not too fazed by your attack. All right, Professor, you're up.
You want to spit fire?
Spitting fire won't do. Is clarify ranged attack or is it like a ranged spell?
It's a ranged attack.
Okay, so not using this.
You can give it to someone else on your team if you want.
I already drank it.
That doesn't matter. You can hand the potion card to
someone. Oh, no, I can still use a ranged attack, just not on ice because it's mathematically impossible to hit him.
So use it on this guy.
Right.
Take that SOB down.
Okay.
Do your thing, Professor.
I shall, and he gets one of these right now. I'm spitting fire. Hot fire.
On the wooden one. Tree. This is excellent.
Hot fire on the tree.
Oh my gosh, the arena has spoken.
Suddenly, a bus drives through the arena, running over a member of the crowd. It turns out it is Rai, clutching a hashtag potion for a random Professor Sator-Krupp.
Rai getting hit by a bus, but a potion gets extended to Coach from the arena. As the crowd cheers, going wild, throwing potions down on Coach.
I have to go with the blue, because I haven't handled the wood yet.
All right, Coach. You're feeling quite interesting after that potion.
Don't know who that is.
A lightning shriek. 3d12 ranged attack only once.
Nice.
Quite powerful. Quite powerful. Thank you, Arena.
We were right there, in fact.
Chantrell could use something, too.
My first attack misses.
Okay, second attack. Do you want to use all three of them
Can I use all three of them?
Yes.
Then I will.
What was that?
Natural 20!
That one hits. That we'll give it a plus two to damage whenever you roll for
Woo-hoo.
That one.
And
the
third one?
And the third one. 13, so 23!
That one also hits. Two hits being extended out. Go ahead and roll that damage for me on Force of Nature. Plus two on the first one being in a fire attack.
Six.
Ten. So 16 points of damage for the first attack.
So 18 total.
No, 16 total.
Oh, so you already added it? Okay.
Yeah. And
14
points of damage for the second attack.
As the fire rings out all around Force of Nature, he begins wilting down.
Tree not feel good.
That's right! Professor Shanks spits hot fire!
Ah. Alright, Chester...
The dopest MC in the arena!
Covington the third, you are up.
Oh, excellent. I shall take a flanking swing at our icicle friend.
Don't miss.
I think I hit this time with a 36.
That will hit. That will hit. So was that a normal attack or a power attack?
It was regular because his armor's ridiculous.
That's true.
For 18 points of damage.
18 points of damage, slamming directly through his armor, smashing into his chest cavity, leaving a small indentation. Oh no, the audience has spoken.
Maybe it's good news.
I can't decide it, guess. I will just have to do both hashtag trap, hashtag potion, random
renegade.
Oh my
god, the audience just starts throwing things from the crowd. The very first, the potion goes to Cantrell. As she bows and accepts her gracious gift.
Orange.
And upon doing so, a tomato immediately hits her in her face as she's about to take a trap too.
Yikes.
Rolled two both times. Sorry.
Sorry.
Take that potion first.
Fine, maybe it'll help counteract the trap.
The faster you drink it, the faster you can get into the game.
I'm trying not to choke.
Oh, that potion is quite special.
Oh, plus gauntlet grog, plus 25 hit points. Restore.
Do you mind handing her one of those gauntlet grogs, one of our very special ales that you can buy only here in the arena, the gauntlet grog, 100% alcohol.
Really?
Go for it. And then, upon taking down that potion, a tomato hits her directly in the face.
Oh.
As a vicious and critical spike was hidden inside that tomato. As it drones down, you see blood running from her forehead.
Yay.
As they had hidden the spike inside the tomato. Your movement is halved. Your next turn.
Gross.
Actually, until you move again, it's just halved.
That's fine.
And you take 4d8 plus 20 worth of damage.
That's okay, because they got these guys.
All right, your first
or
one.
Or you could just take the resurrection.
That's two. Yeah. Four times whatever I roll here.
No, I got it. That's on me. I'm rolling it right now. 42 damage.
Oh, cool.
42 damage as the arena has spoken.
That?
Here's they're like, here's this potion, we love you. And somebody else is like, fuck you.
And again.
Oh, no.
A goblin appears pushing its way through the crowd, yelling, sorry, I'm late, hashtag trap.
Oh my god, a goblin appears. Our favorite goblin, Trogaf, our resident goblin, appears.
Unfortunately.
This is not going well, you guys. Whose idea was this?
Oh,
this is going
fabulously.
Oh, Cantrell, I'm so sorry. This goblin.
Cantrell, God. It's got an H.
He hasn't even got it right once.
An electrifying, painful, noxious gas was released from that goblin as he ran past you. But unfortunately for the rest of you, this gas spreads out across the entire arena, hitting all of you for 2d8 plus 5 worth of damage.
Is that me?
No, all of you.
Oh.
Every one of you is going to get hit by this one. So that's 13 damage spread out across everyone.
But I'm going to use resurrection.
Boom! As she immediately falls to the ground, the audience chants, subscriber! Subscriber! And you are resurrected immediately to anywhere on the battlefield you want with full health.
Anywhere, even if people aren't in there?
No, only places that you have another teammate.
Oh, okay.
A corner.
I would suggest someplace for squishies.
There we go.
There we go. That's, you are back in it. Sorry, we are now back to our regular turn order. I'm not quite sure who is next because we had such a line of wonderful things gifted to us from the arena.
I believe it's,
Coach?
Them.
No, there was the thing with the
you,
thing.
That's yeah. right. You were making an attack on ice, which did hit. So now it's Buddy's turn.
Buddy, if you would please end this ice man.
Oh, man, I'll do what I can. I don't. That superhero his before. Back is turned to me, and I'm gonna light that. I'm gonna light that ass on fire.
That's not something you should say.
Two attacks. The first one hitting. Sparkle.
He's at plus two for all of his attacks.
The second one missing.
Bummer.
So 2d6.
Buddy bummer.
A d6 times 3 plus 2. It's going to be 14 damage as he lights the backside of ice on fire, creating kind of like that
icy hot.
What's that old John Candy movie where the bear's ass is made bare?
Great Outdoors.
Yes, the Great Outdoors. Basically, ice's backside is now completely bare. The, the fur being burned off.
That was brilliant.
As we've got. All right, and force of nature feeling extremely weak. Wants to just end you before he falls, so he kind of takes a long branch and stabs you with it in the gut as he's falling backwards.
That's bought and paid for by a whole
hitting
lot.
Hitting.
How close are you to dying? I can give you this.
For 24 damage. 24 damage.
No, that would put me right at 24 damage.
Oh, do you want this?
That would put me right at 62.
Can I give him, I use the extra attack, but not my 1d12 hit points.
Those, the card has to all be used at one time.
Oh. Well.
So then I'm going to be dying and resurrecting. How many of those resurrections did we have?
We have one more resurrect.
Damn it.
So you die and come back.
I don't think you want to do that.
Nope, I don't.
No.
Why is that?
Because if you do, you'll resurrect right where you are, and that's going to happen anywhere.
Well, I can resurrect anywhere with that, correct?
Any of the four corners, yes. Flank.
So, but he just, bad guy acted. He died. Oh, it's going to be his turn. He can just pop right back where he is anyway. That's how it works.
It's true.
The game may be broken, but it's at least consistent.
But you will, if you don't use that resurrect, you need to use that subscriber resurrect because then you can go immediately
and
finish him
up.
I understand.
I'm going to use
Otherwise,
it.
Otherwise, you have to wait an entire turn, and you're running out of time. So using the subscriber resurrect, the crowd goes wild, and you come right back into it immediately to finish him off as Force of Nature is extremely confused.
Yeah, that'll hit.
How 24? Did you do that?
That hits.
Good job, Coach.
And 23.
Yeah, that will do it as you land the final blow directly into the gut of Force of Nature.
See you later, Tootsie Pop.
You take some of it by opening him up from the inside. The fire that was singed on the outside collects the oxygen and bursts him up into flames from the inside out.
Ooh.
Roll 3d20 for
smell
me.
Like?
3d20. Oh,
just like burning hickory. It's quite nice.
18.
Can I roast some of my mushrooms on it?
10.
We don't have time.
8. And 5. 33. So
33. 33 skulls added to the skull counter. 30 minutes remain. 30 minutes remain. Long way to go to getting into that champion territory.
Do I still get to move?
Yes, you do.
I will move 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 towards ice.
All right. Cantrell, you're up.
Do you guys want my help over there, or should I start, like, investigating this pot?
Let's move together next time.
Yes, let's destroy this one, and then we'll move together.
He's very, very tough.
But I can only move 3. There.
That's fine.
Am I close? Wait, I might be close enough for a magic missile.
That's a good magic missile.
Also, yeah, Burning Hands is 15.
15, it's a 15-foot cone.
Yep.
So it goes out from you, and then...
Oh, okay, then I'm going to use the magic missile.
Magic missile being launched by the wizard across the arena, directly towards ice, hitting him.
15. 4 times 3 is
15.
12.
Plus the 3.
No, it's plus 1 times 3.
Oh. No, it's 1d4 plus 1 times 3.
That's 12.
Well played.
So 12.
12.
12 damage. Missing his reflex save.
Oh, that snap!
Well played, Chantrell.
Thank you.
Whittling down. On ice, still quite a ways to go.
Dang it, guys. Who's got the most... Oh, wait, I did die. So I can use my fireball and my lightning bolt next time. I can get up to 30 points of damage on that bad boy.
Careful with the lightning, I do ask.
Well,
all right. Professor Shanks, you are up.
Fantastic. I will ineffectually strike at this fellow.
Can you punch him with your hand?
You can throw a knife or something.
So you're, you are a rogue, correct? I don't think you have a ranged weapon. You have a bomb.
Oh.
You have a bomb.
Bomb will not work.
It's fire.
Yeah.
It's a radius attack, isn't it?
Yep, I can keep you out of it. Great, I will. I throw a bomb. And because I don't roll a natural 20, I miss.
You miss indeed as the bomb goes wide, missing your target.
Yes, I'm going to have to take care of this place.
I will take a shot.
Covington, taking a shot.
Same with the attacking. Good lord, man. I've missed, buddy. If you would please attack this man.
I feel like I'm underappreciated here. I'm doing all the work.
Buddy, I don't know what else to tell you. It
first
seems
one
to
hits.
Be how it works.
Second one misses.
Are you adding the plus two he gets for flanking?
He doesn't. Buddy doesn't. But that second hit gives 17, or that first hit 17 damage on ice, again whittling him down quickly.
Well, thank God for small miracles.
We gotta make this quick, guys, and then figure out where we want to go.
Ice, now quite angered by continually getting hit on his backside, lifts up on who's that directly in front of him? Is that
that's Covington?
That would be me.
Lifts up Covington with his horns, pushing him forward 6 spaces up against that wall.
Oh, your color description does not matter. I'm quite dead.
Already dead?
Do a point. I'm dead.
Yeah, you took any damage at all? You were down? Yeah,
yes.
You were down. As he lifts you up, he just rips directly through your body as his horns tear into you, ripping you in half as you fall off both sides and he runs forward. You are out of resurrects at the moment, so, and that he's the only enemy currently on the board, so you are backup coach.
Okay. Any help would be great.
I'm not a backup coach. I'm a primary coach. I'm the number one coach.
No,
all three of the team.
No, you're actually a sub. Let's be honest.
I'm not a sub. I have tenure.
Since when?
Coach with the thing.
I'm gonna move right up to this guy here, and then I'm gonna go with this lightning shriek, 3d12 ranged attack.
Wow, this is an impressive attack. Now first, let's see, roll for that hit.
And that's off the range, same?
Yes.
Oh. 19. 18.
Total?
No.
I'll let you save that card. Now, let's see, that's one attack, but for 3d12, I'll let you save it until it actually hits. Because it is a quite powerful card. I'd hate for it to just go to waste just like that. Cantrell, you are up.
Cantrell. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, look at this guy, and aim my magic missile.
Another magic missile, an automatic hit on that. Now go ahead and roll your damage for me.
4.
12.
Damage. Starts just getting more and more angry as he's raging out.
Is that it? That was not very exciting.
I think he's going to go on a rampaging frenzy.
Yeah, he's
going to
go on a rampage here real soon. Professor Shanks, you're up.
I'm going to throw another bomb. I have a lot of these things, right?
All yes.
Right.
You have never...
So underhanded, just...
Yeah, it doesn't say how many of these bombs you have, so we'll say, yeah, you've got a lot of them.
I've got a lot of them. A lot. And I didn't roll a 20, so no, I miss again.
The episode... Unending, I believe. You have one of those magic pouches to just throw.
Great.
Are you a rogue or an alchemist?
I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just to move.
All right, you're keeping him on his toes. Covington, you're up.
I'll appear in the corner and say, bring it!
All right, as you stand there, just kind of waiting, staring at him, ice.
Buddy, if you would please hit this man.
Oh, that's right. Buddy, once again, hey man, you want me to, like, come into the room and you know, like hang out with you guys. I feel kind of bad. Hanging
I missed
out back
you,
here.
Buddy.
Still with a behind attack, unable to see it coming. Toon just cover him in lightning bolts as he goes. The first attack hits. Second attack misses once again.
Good show, buddy.
That D6.
Batting 500.
1 and 3, 12 is 14 damage. Buddy is just continuing to light him up.
Thank you, buddy.
Ooh.
Now things are getting extremely interesting. Extremely interesting. As Ice enrages and just his eyes go red and he starts rampaging around the room, picking up, looks like Coach here, by his horns, and then making his way over to Shanks and picking him up on the other horn and throwing them into the fountain.
Oh, that fountain.
Did not
throwing them
see that
into
coming.
The fountain.
How mad he looks. He looks pissed.
He looks very angry.
I mean, I'm just going to step out of the room,
I think he's got some aggression issues that Dr. Covington over there.
Causing 8 damage, but upon throwing you into the fountain, knowing what he was doing, he sets off a trap inside the fountain. And a pastry-filled, brutal swinging axe.
Ooh. That sounds yummy.
How much damage did we take from that?
Comes flying out from underneath as the two of you take...
Get pastry to death?
A lot of damage.
Okay, dead.
It's going to be 6, 8...
Oh, Professor, I'm so sorry to see that happen.
19... Yep. Holy shit.
Never played a rogue again.
These brutal ones are pretty overpowered.
Is it more than 8?
Yes, it's 40 damage after the pastry field.
Okay, I die.
40 damage to both of you as you land in that fountain where the axe, the pastry filled axe, comes slamming down on you. I like how pastry filled is a +2 to damage. I don't know what it is, but that's quite funny.
Sugar, maybe?
You're okay though, right?
Oh, no, I wouldn't use the word okay exactly.
You're
I feel kind of like I got hit by Richard Sherman.
So it's your turn?
And a wall.
Yep, Coach, you are up.
Well, I'm gonna stand back up.
Standing back up.
And I'm gonna,
do your lightning shriek again?
Yeah, I'm not, because I just looked at the bonus for my range and I can't hit, a 30.
I understand.
So I'm just gonna move up and to his, rear and use my club to
spank him,
hit him right on his bare
pound
ass.
Him
you're gonna
right
basically,
on his bare ass.
You still believe in corporal punishment at your university with your...
Only with large ice creatures that have impaled me twice with their horns.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Unable to resist his bare ass, making a giant slap towards it.
21.
That will not hit.
11.
Also not going to hit. Sing,
big
swing
money.
He kind of puckers up and like rears up as you miss and swing.
This guy might even be coconut competition for me.
Cantrell, you're up.
Cantrell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm
Cantrell.
Going to
I believe she's been broken.
Wabbit season.
I am going to throw my fireball at him.
Throwing a fireball is an automatic hit.
Well played.
Now, that fireball has a range area attack, right?
Shit sticks. Yeah, 20.
Yeah, move up less.
Okay.
Otherwise, you get killed by it.
And if you put it somewhere over there, then
put it somewhere over here, it'll hit these guys.
What's its range? What's
Buddy, I'll be fine.
20 feet?
Yeah.
Oh, yep, go for it.
In the middle, it'll be fine.
That's usually how it works.
Two,
so that's 10?
10.
10 damage as the fireball hits in the middle, burning some more hair off the right side of Ice, and +2 to that for fire, so we're gonna call it 12 damage. As it kind of hits Buddy too, and he's kind of like, what are you, like, I know you can't hurt me, man, but come on, I'm not feeling appreciated right now.
Buddy, I appreciate you greatly.
You're a little in the way.
We're just warming up to you there, buddy.
All right, Professor, you're up.
Do it.
I come back onto the battlefield.
Yes, so you just now resurrecting into a corner, unable to move or attack.
That's okay. Both of those things were ineffectual for me versus this monster anyway.
All right, and...
Professor, why don't you compose a sonnet?
Can you not do anything against this?
I am.
I shall move and attack and flank, and then, buddy, if you would attack him as well. I do appreciate your work, buddy. We would not be able to do anything against him without you right now. No, it's a 14, it's 32.
That is just enough to hit.
Excellent, that's 26 plus. 36 points of pound.
36 points of pound as you hit his now half-charred face as it turns to you. As it smashes into his skull, it splits and his eyes pop out of their sockets as his very muscular body slams to the ground.
Oh boy.
As you make once again another kill, our barbarian rolls three.
Honest ice.
Three.
D20. I wish I had a Dremel and could destroy your miniature, you little piece of shit. Good lord.
Yeah, we hate
so
that.
What was
guy.
That?
It was bad. Now I'm at 6 and 19 is 25. Ugh. 29.
29 more skulls added to the overall score as the crowd goes wild. There are only 17 minutes remaining. 17 minutes remaining in this battle. Now, there are options here. You could betray your new friend.
No, he's one of us right now.
All right.
There's only one here.
Besides, I'd like to end up in the ice room and get rid of him there.
Oh, there we go.
Let's go this way.
Yes. So we all head into this room over here?
Yes. Buddy, come with us. So, buddy, how did you find yourself in this gauntlet in the first place? I'm quite interested in your story.
You know, I was moonlighting for jobs and stuff. It's kind of rough out there being a fire monster, you know?
I can see.
People kind of look down on you and stuff, but at least when I'm doing a job like this, like, I'm kind of famous, you know? And
someone should
attack
the golden
statue. I get a lot of privileges for doing
that. I'll do that.
A lot of risk with the job, but...
You're my favorite, buddy.
I've enjoyed you, buddy. You did so much work last time.
I appreciate that. I appreciate that. It's all about being respected.
No, I respect you
greatly. It's all about respect.
That's treacherous.
You know, now that you mention it, you know, Blaze never really respected me anyway.
It's like nacho cheese.
Always bossing me around.
Would someone like to hit the golden statue?
I'll gladly hit that thing.
So you all just took your turns up there, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, the golden statue is going to get to move first here.
Yes.
As he sees it, one of the great leaders of those who have come before you, you will kneel down and respect my authority. As he takes his axe and slams it down on top of the barbarian, hitting for 2 damage.
Not
too bad. As it hits your helmet and kind of
battle axe stuck in your helmet, coach.
Yes.
I didn't wear a helmet.
More your damage comes from just the ringing in your ears that have made you temporarily deaf.
Coach, would you like to do the honors?
I'll gladly do the honors here. That'll be a 19.
That'll hit.
And the second one would be a 27.
Yeah, and how do you want to destroy him?
Utterly and completely.
Yeah, okay.
You should badminton him to death.
Exactly like
baseball
that.
Baseball him out of the arena.
Oh, yeah. Head right
once
out.
And taking another...
Into the cheese sauce.
Oh, into the cheese dip. Hitting him up and over the wall, landing back down in the cheese dip as he sinks... Bloom, 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 down into a roll of D6 for me.
It's going to be a nacho monster in a minute.
Three more skulls added to the board.
We're going to make it. You guys make your moves into the ice room.
You might make it if there aren't any more traps that are laid upon you.
I want to add some mushrooms to this pot.
Great. As I said, unless there's more traps added upon you. That does happen to be a trap. So as you start adding mushrooms into the pot, Cantrell.
You're killing me, Smalls. You're killing me.
As you throw some mushrooms in there, looks like some remnants of force of nature in this area remain as... some extra horrid vines start coming out of the pot and wrapping themselves around you. You take a lot of damage
here. I was trying to be creative.
I'm not sure that's how this
Botany
works.
Isn't a real profession.
As they squeeze you, you take 31...
Quiet with your Suedo fake accent.
You take 31 damage.
You said Suedo.
As they pick you up and squeeze you, sucking
the life out of
you.
It doesn't work.
Mine
make fun
works.
Of your stupid accent.
I don't have an accent.
What, no,
I am Northwestern.
That's like Midwestern chipmunk, right?
No.
Yeah, see?
Shanks.
She just did it.
All right, you guys are you're up, Shanks. You've got 13 minutes left on the clock.
Quickly into the
can I take
we're
some
closer
of this
to the, we're closer to
let's move this way.
We're closer to the cheese whiz room.
It's not there anymore?
Look where we're all at. We're closer to the cheese whiz.
All right. We'll move
That's
in.
That's me. You're here.
Right, I can move into Cheese Whiz from here.
Fine, and I didn't
right
move.
There.
I just...
What do I see?
Well, as you come across that room...
I'll make a reflex
and you look at the, can you make a... No, we'll just say to keep this moving, you don't have to make any save there. As you enter the room, the cheese starts bubbling as Thumper starts emerging out of the cheese dip, covered in cheese around his face as he's just been... sucking in as much of the cheese dip as he absolutely can, and Thumper enters the arena.
Interesting.
Great. I'll throw a grenade at him then.
Throwing a grenade directly at Thumper.
Well played.
Thank you. 28.
That will hit. That will hit. How much damage?
It's... That's right. Yes, plus two. Good.
3, 7, 11, 13.
13.
Avanti! Oh no, oh no.
Long way to go to whittle Thumper down. All right, Covington, you're up.
I will move in twice and I will send Buddy and ask Buddy so kindly. I will distract him if you would be so kind as to attack Mr. Buddy.
All right, sending Buddy in as well.
Yes, Buddy, I believe, is firing from a distance. Is this correct?
That's correct. He has range.
Buddy, if you would be so kind as to attack this one.
Oh, hey, what's
I shall
up, Thumper Man?
And keep you safe.
I'm really sorry I gotta do this. I'm currently under the powers of this guy's sexual aura. I can't really deny his wants and needs and wishes, so I hope we're still good to go catch that game later, but here's some fire for your face.
I'm like it old and crusty.
Misses the first attack, and the second one... Also misses, both attacks missing as he's shooting from a distance and he just can't seem to get quite a pin
it's
on.
It's okay, buddy. These things happen.
Yeah, it does happen. It does happen. So that was Buddy's turn as well. As Thumper now seeing, who is that we've got right underneath him?
I'm right here, you
guys. Yes, yes. Seeing Covington right underneath him, still hungry from all that cheese dip that he couldn't quite finish ingesting, reaches down and lands a massive bite on top of your head.
I'm not surprised.
That's where all the knowledge is.
For 16 damage.
Okay.
16
Brains
damage.
Are pretty tasty, I guess.
He just couldn't resist all that hair.
Or all that crazy.
All right, so that is it for his turn. Coach, you're up.
Is
Think
that
resubscribe?
Right there, close enough to attack?
Yep.
I'm going to lightning shriek him.
Lightning shriek, taking that lightning shriek. This is a good move to throw in at this point of the game.
19.
Not enough to hit. Mm. Yeah, once again, a wasted move. We go up to Cantrell.
Cantrell! I am going to move, obviously. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm going to hit this
Some massive moves need to be made quickly. Only 10 minutes remain.
Go on,
and at 111...
Both,
the only chance they have of, go ahead and throw that lightning bolt. The only chance they have of winning is if
we kill both of them.
Both of them in 10 minutes.
25.
I have an idea.
25 damage smashing into Thumper. All right, keep it going. Just keep going down the line. We'll try to move quickly for you guys.
Who's next?
Shanks.
For the memories.
Make enough room so that Thumper or that Buddy can get in there.
Done.
Hit him.
And you're attacking.
I am. From behind.
Backstab.
Mm-hmm. Shanks style. 19.
Not hit. Enough to hit.
You get a plus two with the flank.
Ah, 21.
Not enough to hit.
Bummer. I shall attack.
25 AC on Thumper.
Oh. That'll hit. Then if it's 25 with a whopping 20.
Is that a power attack or a normal attack?
Yes, that's why I'm missing with the four. 14 plus 12 is 26. So a d12 plus 26 would be...
It's gonna be a big hit.
34 points.
34 hits of damage from the barbarian with his giant spear as it goes slashing across the Thumper's chest. Now, what do you want Buddy to do in this situation?
Buddy, if you would please enter the room and attack, I shall continue to distract him.
Okay, man. Hey, go take some fire right up.
Less talking, more fighting.
Okay, fine now. First one hits. Second one does not. First one hits.
What is that?
It's the sound that could probably be bad, but could be good.
A goblin with nacho chips walks into the room, sees what's going on back away with his cheese dip, and pulls a level hashtag trap.
Oh my god! These goblins running crazy throughout the arena once again as Covington gets a trap thrown on him. A salty and moderate spider.
That's just Covington.
You are now, you have no effect from the saltiness other than you are now extremely salty.
Oh.
And you take.
innuendo, in your endo. Wasn't that salty?
And you take 27
broke
damage.
Two of them.
27 damage.
27 damage.
Which brings us to me.
Which brings us to Thumper. As
Thumper.
Thumper spins around after getting that attack on the ass there and brings his mighty club slamming down on top of the rogue.
He felt it as a gentle caress.
Isn't that always the way?
But actually misses his attack.
Oh, thank God.
Jesus. All right, so now you're up, Coach.
I am going to move one closer to make sure that I am off of a square away from her, and I'm going to whirlwind attack all adjacent enemies.
So you're hitting both enemies. Sure. When you say whirlwind, you're going to do one hit on one and one hit on the other, correct?
I was going to send him into the ice room to take care of it that way.
But this will unleash another bad
guy. You've only got 7 minutes.
We've only got 7 minutes. We're going to go both.
Go for it.
All right, one attack. Well, who do you want the first attack to be on?
Thumper and then Buddy.
Okay, first attack on Thumper.
Is a 17.
Not going to hit. Second attack.
Is a 23.
That will hit. That second attack damage for me.
It is 17.
17, as you start whittling away on
Buddy.
On Buddy. Hey, man, what are you doing, man? What the hell? Was that an accident?
Totally on accident. I just got spun like around, hell. And sorry about that.
All right, Cantrell, you're up.
Cantrell.
What are you hitting? What are you doing? You should lightning strike.
What you doing?
You want to give it to me?
Yes.
You want to use it? Use it. We need that damage.
Do it.
Do I have for the to love. For it?
There's 2 minutes.
It's a ranged attack.
So what do I get
to
add?
You actually have to roll the attack. She's a wizard, so.
But she doesn't have a ranged bonus, so she would just hit, right?
No.
I like how you think.
I think because it's not magic and it says attack. It actually, she's the hardest to hit because she doesn't have a.
In that case, probably shouldn't give that to
you. Okay, fine. Then I'm going to shoot my last lightning bolt out of his butthole.
Oh.
Right, shooting a lightning bolt
we
right
call
up his
that
butthole.
The shocker.
Yeah, it's called shot to the butthole.
Shot to the butthole automatically hits for 10 damage on Thumper as he jumps up, swinging his club wildly throughout the air. Shanks, you're up.
Nice.
5 minutes remain.
Yeah, I shank. Specifically. That's the move I'm using.
You're going to shank.
I'm shanking.
Shank it. Thank you very much.
My Mr. Roboto. Yes, 22.
Unfortunately, you once again do not
hit. Flanking. 24.
He's right in front of you.
I'm still flanking.
But he's flanking.
We're flanking adjacent. Therefore, I get a flanking bonus because there's somebody behind him.
Okay. All right. I will allow that. So 24 is not enough to hit.
Okay. That was a 12-second argument that didn't need to happen.
I will power again. Hopefully, it can. That should. It's 12 plus. That is a 30 to hit. Plus 26. 30 points of damage.
30 points of damage. The barbarian once again coming in extremely fucking strong. Thumper barely getting any attacks and starting to feel quite weak himself.
Buddy, if you could please finish this one off.
Buddy.
Come on, buddy, hit him.
All right, man.
Thank you, sir.
I feel like I'm in a bad position here. I don't trust you guys.
I'm gonna move. Don't
First
worry.
Hits.
Unless I trip, it won't happen again.
Second one misses.
12 damage, still up.
Thank
Thumper
you, buddy.
Is still up. 12 damage on Thumper. Thumper is now up as he swings, turning around and swings his axe, hitting all three that are standing in a line.
Sounds
giant good. Club, so spin his body around there.
Standing in the... That's not me, right?
Hitting all three of you that are sitting right next to the front there. For...
You're hitting Buddy, too?
For 10, yes. Hitting Buddy for 10.
No problem. How are you doing, Buddy?
Oh, man, I'm okay. I'm about, like, half health and everything.
Good
but
to know.
Little,
thank
yeah,
you, buddy.
You know.
All right, Coach.
It's up to me.
Yep. 3 minutes remain.
Whirlwind attack.
Hitting who first? That's important.
Same him.
Okay.
And that's 23 flanking 25.
That'll hit.
You don't get a flanking bonus. You're not a rogue.
Everybody gets a flanking
everybody
bonus.
Gets flanking
not on these rules.
Oh, no.
Only the rogue.
Oh.
I'm the only one who gets a bonus to damage from flanking, I thought.
According to this sheet, since you guys are all level 5, I don't see anything in here about that plus 2 for AC.
It's just a basic rule of Pathfinder.
I'll allow it. This one time, I'll allow it. So that's a 25, you said?
Right at 25.
That'll hit.
Second one will be 19.
Second one misses.
On Buddy. That's on Buddy.
First one hits.
Okay.
Roll your damage.
Damage is on big old, that's 15. No, sorry, 12.
12 will do it as Thumper falls to the ground, into the cheese dip as he sinks down, immediately losing consciousness, and drowns himself, sucking up the cheese dip into his lungs. Roll 3d20s for me.
Two. 22. And 42!
42 total points added to the skull counter. You have 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining.
Sorry, buddy.
I'm gonna.
Hey, man, what's going on? I don't like the sound of this.
I am burning.
No, man.
I'm gonna use this lightning.
It's a ranged attack. He said she doesn't get a good thing with it.
She doesn't get a bonus for that.
So should I do burning hands or magic missile?
Nothing fire.
Magic missile. I'm doing a
magic missile. Magic missile shooting towards Buddy.
Get a four.
Nine.
Misses his reflex save. Shanks, you're up.
Go to flank, Shanks.
Shanks, flanks, then Shanks.
Flank, Shanks, then Shanks.
Nice, 27.
That'll hit.
Thank you. All right, 11 damage.
11 damage. Man, this sucks.
Wait. 14 damage.
This really sucks.
Buddy, I'm sorry with the power.
This really sucks, man. I've been helping you guys out this whole time. What's going on?
You missed.
Buddy's turn.
He puts his hands down on the ground, letting off lava stream around him that shoots you all up into the air as it kind of burns your feet, throwing you up into the air. Everyone that's adjacent to him, which is all four of you, that hits no one. I rolled a one.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, we went for a ride.
Coach.
For the school.
That's a 23.
That hits.
Second attack is a 14.
Misses.
Do your damage, coach.
Damage is 11.
Do your 11. Thing, Chantrell. Still standing. Still standing.
Cantrell. Shit, Chantrell. Like shit. Five.
Two.
What's that?
No, it's 10. Much?
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's 10. You got 1 + 1 = 2 times 5 is 10.
No, that's
times
3.
3.
2 so, times 3 is 5.
6.
6. Okay. All right, and
go, Professor.
Shanks. I thought it was
Shanks. 41 seconds remain.
No, Shanksing. No. What is that? I don't even know.
Well, what is it?
30 seconds remain.
Missed. Okay.
Yours.
Power one more time, please. Damn it.
Miss.
Buddy.
As Buddy then turns and shoots the lava one, and I roll the one again.
All right.
No, go.
19. 24.
Hits.
And the damage is 14.
Do a magic missile.
As
does he go?
Buddy falls to the ground.
Ah! You betrayed me, man. What the fuck?
I gotta hit him.
Seriously, or one. No, he's dead. He's dead. He's dead.
Roll 20.
All right, the clock is up, and I will wait.
18. 33. 53.
Oh my God, he saved our clock. Woo! Everybody!
Well done, Coach! Well done,
Coach! I like it's a 206!
Professor, that was beautiful!
Just like our Pacific Northwest
Unit. Holy cow! Oh, our research is saved!
Composure! Everyone be cool! Remember, we're academics! Act like academics, damn it!
You've been here before! Would you like a mushroom?
I rolled 2 ones in a row in the last 2 turns!
I saw that. That was awesome.
That sucks. That's a tough break.
Don't worry, we'll get you your pay later.
Oh!
What do we win? What? Money?
You win my respect and the current crown trophy.
Woohoo!
We'll get a picture after this show. You are current leaders with the trophy.
203 skulls?
206.
We the 206.
We live in direct. 206.
It's wonderful.
Northwest for life.
Holy crap. Buddy, I shall be teaching my students about you for years.
Quite impressive demonstration. You all can catch this wonderful group on Friday night. They will be playing Death from Above Renegades, where hopefully I can find some way to punish them for their performance here today.
Oh, dear Lord.
Thank you all for joining us. We have coming up next the Cineverse, a year of training having to be realign there. Cineverse is up next. It'll be all our favorite geeks talking about movies, and you guys will get to interact with that show, giving them all sorts of tasks and having fun in the chat room, talking to them about all the new movies that are coming out. And I would like to remind everyone that there are many other ways you can support HyperRPG, and one of those ways is to get the new Cineverse t-shirt that is up on Amazon. If you scroll down and click the Amazon merch store. Actually, Mark, come here. Why don't you stand right in the middle, Mark?
Yeah,
stand right in the middle, Mark. Look at that.
That's
awesome.
A great
awesome
t-shirt.
Awesome. Look at that awesome shirt that you can pick up in the Amazon store right now.
Yeah.
The other thing is, I don't know if you guys knew this or not, but I'm currently running for office in 2020 for president, Overlord for President 2020. You can pick up that shirt on Teespring. Just scroll down. 2020 Overlord for President. Get it trending. Get that shirt. Wear it. Make your kids wear it. We have them in kid sizes as well.
Awesome. I can finally something that fits me.
Greatly appreciated. Thank you guys so much for participating tonight.
We are going to
put the waiting screen up, and we will be right back in a little bit with Cineverse.
Yay! Yay!